This is a playlist that I stole from YouTube of relaxing Dreamcast music. This is Fantasy Star Online. Okay, so this is from Zabel VGM. So if you want to find Zabel VGM's playlist of relaxing Dreamcast music, that is the answer that you're looking for. Now let's see if I can balance this audio right. I'll say that's good enough. Let's see, so what am I going to do today? Oh, well, first thing I'm going to do, I have to edit the stream info, because this is all wrong. This is so annoying. I swear, they could have just, like... Okay, let's do a level design. Let's put finishing up. The gravity gun level. Named Gamedev and Godot engine. Can I do like a preview? I really wish that there's just some sort of like presets. Actually, I'm gonna look that up right now. Twitch. Stream info presets. Also, pretty soon my oven's gonna beep because I'm preheating a thing. Oh, well, there is a website called Twitch Stream Presets, which asks you to log in with Twitch, so that's a pretty nice that that gap is being filled in by a website that asks you for your user info. But okay, that's not what this is. This isn't the streaming stream. This is the video game development stream for the video game At the Ends of Eras. Look at this. I'll double click it. So this Sunday, I fixed my water effects. I can go through a little bit of that. Let's see. Let's open the folder here. Where was it? I think it was mostly GLES3, rasterizer, probably rasterizer storage, GLES3. Because I think it was render target allocate. Yeah. The main thing was I needed to change a depth buffer. I needed to change this. So it used to be a GL depth attachment, I think, or something like that, or GL depth component attachment, or whatever it is. Now it's GL depth stencil attachment. And then it's, I'm pretty sure, mostly compatible with everything else that was in the changes that I stole from somebody's GitHub for version 3.1. But I don't know if it ever worked. I don't know when they put viewports in, or render targets in, because this seems like it was like, because that's just how it makes this. Like, this is a render target. So that's why it didn't work here. But it might have worked in-game. I don't know, actually. But long story short, I now have beautiful water. But it murders the performance, and also there's still a slight performance. Or there's still a slight... Oh, I just realized what that is. I was like, oh, why is that rectangle there? I was wondering if it was, like, something busted. But it's because I had made my... Whoop, that's the wrong one. I made this unshaded, or I made this shaded. And eventually I can make this like a nicer looking thing. Yeah, there we go. So that was to test to make sure that I was getting the right faces and stuff. But yeah, now it draws a stencil of the water shape itself in the stencil buffer. And it doesn't do anything there, it's just a multiply of white. Actually, I wonder if, hang on, I'm gonna test something right now. Okay, so that does, affect the stencil, that makes sense. There's my oven. I'll put a pizza in the oven and I'll be back in a minute. And that'll scream at me is 18 minutes from now. That's what that's gonna do. Anyway, I'm gonna fiddle with these. I thought of something to say and then I forgot it. Oh, now I remember. The box of my pizza, it's a stuffed crust pizza, but it says on the box, over 2 feet of cheese. And I don't get it because feet is not a unit of cheese. That's not a thing. Like, you don't measure cheese in feet. And also, it's a 12-inch pizza, so if they're measuring by, like, how much cheese is in the crust, by, like, the distance around the crust, it should be more than 2 feet. It should be, like, 3 feet, because it's the circumference of the pizza. Also, there's a slight thing here where transparent objects let you see through the water, but that's okay. And I may have to make a simplified water shader as well, just in case the player, well, what I would do essentially is probably just add a collision for the camera, so that way you can't like go through the water. And then I would have some funky little thing so that some funky little system, because it does, the stencils do, I think, impact rendering time a little bit. Like, they're not negligible entirely. And the refractions as well. So I'll have to, maybe just make him transparent. So that way it doesn't have to sample the textures. But I do think it's like, I just like refractions. They're very pretty. But anyway, that's enough of this. We were doing, last I left off, we had just finished up this gravity area, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to start a new game. I'm going to get the pistol, and I'm going to teleport to there. So let's just do... Let's give myself 10 rounds of pistol ammo, and then we'll teleport to, where is it? 90. Or 89, or something like that. There we go. There's something weird with the, yeah, there's something quite off with the... Oh wait, no, is that the area? What is this? Because basically, I was fiddling with this. Oh yeah, and I also fixed my issue that I was having on Saturday. I forgot that I have apply fog that updates every frame, and that sets the distance if the environment... It used to be just if the environment was overridden. Now it also checks if the tween is active, because that's going to tween between active and inactive. And hopefully, and this shouldn't change too much, because basically what I'm thinking is if the player starts the tween and then they fall a really big distance, this fog will change. But that's okay. Also, my room is kind of smoking a little bit, so I'll have to clean my oven soon. I keep cleaning it. It's very, like, I cleaned it a bunch. But I can still smell smoke. I think it's because at one point, or now I'm getting kind of jumpy about smoke, because at one point, my smoke detector went off at like 8:30 at night, and I just got stressed out about it. Because it's also, my ceiling is too high for me to reach it. I had to put down I had to stand on a table to actually reach the thing, because it's like 10.5 feet tall, this apartment. Okay, but what is up with this thing? So I am here. The fog is normal. Let's teleport to 90, maybe? Yeah, okay. So I'm here now. Wait, did I? I lost my pistol again. Wait, where's the... Oh, there it is. See, I did an interesting thing where I brought the fog closer in instead of making it darker. Because I don't really need there to be, like, dark black fog. What I want is to sort of emulate, like, exposure. By basically, when you go into here, it brings the fog in, like that, and it turns off the sun. So that way it's like, you know, it's like blasting out there. And then you come back out and it's like, it goes back to normal. I bet I could fiddle with exposure settings to, like, mask those things. Like, it's like, oh, it's just the camera changing exposure, when in reality... Oh, wait, hang on. I'm gonna add the pistol now, because the player should at least have that by the time that they're actually, like, out here. Okay, so this is... Actually, let's make sure. So yeah, it's gonna be pretty obvious that this way is blocked. Well, let's test it. Yeah, I don't think the player's gonna get in there. Actually, while I'm here, I should do the important task. Chunk, gravity gun. Of putting down bugs and things. So let's just change this. No, let's add a... For now, I'm just gonna do... I'm not gonna overthink it. I'm just gonna have one multi-mesh system right there. And then I'll have a bunch of gems and bugs that are children of it. And his brother will be here. I think here I'm gonna kind of do the opposite of what I usually do, where I like try to guide the player to the right place. I might just put them a bit more evenly, so that way it's like, you know, it kind of, I want to incentivize the player to just wander around this place. And eventually I might even make it like cool, like I might put stuff in here. Oh yeah, another thing I've been thinking about is that this game effectively won't mean anything until I start putting in like little details, and ironically those little details are also like the things that have to be put in last. Let's see, this music's kind of overwhelming me. I like it a little quieter, and maybe a little louder on your end. But essentially, you know, a game is nothing but little details. You know, thousands of little details over and over again. And, let's see, I'll make this sublime. And there'll also be a less interesting coat. Or I guess this one, I'll make this one not persistent, and it'll have a random chance of being up to super rare. And this one, I'll make it go from super rare to sublime. So that way the player can get, like, less rare coats. Actually, hang on. I'm gonna not have bugs. I'm gonna save and quit. Yeah, because, like, this place won't mean anything until there's, like, a bunch of, like, aesthetic details to hint what it is. Also, I don't really know what it is yet. Let's get some bugs and all sorts of good nonsense in here. I don't know if there'll be any gems in here. Ooh, something that'd be kind of cool. I think the player can just roll jump off of the wall and then just get these, but this is still kind of, I think it'd be fun. Also, I wonder if this one is accessible. Let's put all of the other pickups in here as well, except for, I guess, the random ammo pickups, because those have to do, I don't know if those have to do anything specific, because they just, it might be good to keep them, like, constrained, though. Yeah, I'll keep some of those constrained. I should put an enemy in here. Also, I should make this... This vent is a little bit too small, maybe. These janked out quads. And also, I think at the end of today, I'm gonna play more Elden Ring. I'm probably just gonna play more Elden Ring multiplayer, because I've been, I don't know. I think I like the repetition now. Though, actually, now that I've said that, I may just not stream. Well, actually, nah, I won't stream. Even if I do play Elden Ring. Because I'll just do, multiplayer in my free time. Either that, or I've also been practicing bass again. Because, well... I guess not really again, honestly. I have a bass, and I've played it a little bit in, like, simple songs, but I haven't actually, like, practiced, like, bass lines and stuff like that, so I'm gonna do that after the stream. Let's see, and this should be a room for the medium, so I'm gonna reserve this. Let's do a 2-do medium. Let's get numb. Oh, okay, it's down here. This place is very impressive. It's very... Well, I like this place. I think I did a good job. So I'm gonna say, she'll be here, she'll be cool. But yeah, eventually I need to make a mouth for her. Well, I need to just sculpt her face, because currently her eyes are, like, drawn on and stuff, which used to be there, but... Let's also make it conditional, so it'll be, it'll just not show up. Well, I don't know if that actually works, I'll just hide it. And that way, I know that I've reserved this room for the medium, so the player can, like, see, their mom again. Wait, what's it? Huh? What? Wasn't I gonna put something in here? What is this? Like, actually, what is this room? Oh, I think I was gonna make this another balance room? And then I just didn't. And then I just never did. Okay. And pizza in T-minus 50 seconds. Mm-hmm. Yep, there it is. See, I'll be back in a second. Sorry, it took me a bit. I had to wash my pizza cutter because I forgot I had pizza last night. Okay, but now what am I gonna do with this thing? Did I honestly think this was gonna do anything? What did I even have in here? How did this happen? Oh well, I'll have something fun in there. Maybe it'll be like visual. Huh. Sorry, I forgot I had my BRB screen on. I meant this thing. I don't know what this is. Or I don't know how I missed that this is empty. Oh well. I think it'll just be some fun little aesthetic thing. Maybe I'll put some, I know, I'll put a death gnat in here. Oh. And I'll put, I don't know, some baubles. Basically, it'll just be like simple cover, and it'll. I want to teach the player that they can distort projectiles with this as well. So this might get the player working on that. Yeah, okay, now this is a combat arena. Okay, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna stop placing bugs. I'm gonna play a little bit. I'm gonna play through this. So we got... And my fridge decided to go. Okay, we got some ammo. And this should teach the player. Oh, cool, like that. And then that light is not activated far enough. Which is this one? Maybe like 90? Oh wait, this might be because, this might actually be because of visibility. Hang on. Yeah, I think it's that there's too many visible lights. Yeah, all of the lights are going all fucked up. I'll have to split it into I'll just have to split the, this object into multiple meshes. But okay, I'll keep track of that. I'll even have my, I don't know how my table and my office chair always get so wrangled together. But okay, let's say finishing touches on the gravity cannon level will be, let's see, split mesh for lights. Okay. And I'm gonna mute and eat pizza while I play. Now that I think about it, there's actually a lot of relevant commentary here. But basically, I forgot that this was an elevator, so the player's not gonna figure that out. So I'm gonna put a bobble and enemies right next to it. To encourage shooting it. And right now, also the other thing I had was, I'm gonna make that initial room have a lower bobble, so that way you can just jump up to one of them. And also, I'd like the hallways to be, well, I need to add bevels. I'll also just list that. Let's see. Add bevels to floor. So yeah, split the mesh, and then some gameplay tweaks. Alright, I completely forgot already. This is how to progress. And then this might be their introduction to cloaked enemies, so I think it'd be kind of fun. So RS to toggle aim. And then the guy is, he's gone. Why is he invisible? Where did he go? Why do my guys keep disappearing? What are they doing? Was he nomad? No, it doesn't seem like he was nomadic. Oh, it's just a different hallway. There's two different hallways. Are there? No, wait. Where the fuck is he? What? How did I do that? How did I manage that? Literally, what was I thinking? How did I do this? How did I just put him in the wrong place? Okay, there he is. So it'll tutorialize this now. So hopefully the player tries to shoot him, realizes they can't. Okay, I feel like that's clear enough. It's like framing it almost exactly where the player is going to be if they're like looking out the window. They may not understand what that means though. Well, hopefully they do. It's fairly intuitive. It's just blocking it physically. Oh yeah, didn't I make that the room that you can get a shortcut to? I really like the idea of, like, organically making a bunch of shortcuts in this area. So, like, you do this, you know, puzzle to hop down into this room. Okay, so I really, really, really need to fix that. Because it's trivial to, like, push yourself out of bounds and then that messes you up. Hang on. Alright, this is looking pretty good. So, I also want to fix the camera in narrow spaces. So I have some ideas on how to do that. The main one being, just don't have the camera, like, able to clip through the world when you're crouching. Oh, right, I almost forgot that. So I was about to jump out this window. So hopefully that signals to the player that this is a dangerous area, but it also should be a signal to you that I'm going to get more pizza. All right. So the player might have like health up and stamina up and stuff like that at this point. Maybe even like pistol damage up and pistol capacity up if I can manage that. So I see those guys. Why are they like weird? Oh, they aggroed to me at some point. They're seriously like screwed up now. What are they doing? Oh, there they go. Oh, they didn't know where I was. Okay, yeah, I really need to fix these things. They do not run very well. And it seems to be specifically the projectiles. You know, that when at a certain point, when a bunch of them are activated, let's see. Maybe it must be a combination of the physics bodies and, yeah. Wait, why is... It's always specifically when I'm at this angle, though. Why is that? Is it the collisions with this thing, maybe? Hang on, what if we aren't colliding with that? Let's see, I need to figure out. Wait, what else do I need? Oh, this guy. And then this thing. I mean, I kind of... Let's see. Maybe I should indicate to the player that the... You know, the tower that explodes when you take the capacitor is like a one-off thing. Like, it's a special case. You know, that there's other places where it's safe to take capacitors from, because otherwise I think they're going to be disincentivized from actually doing that. Okay, and hopefully... I suspect the player will be able to explore this place just fine without giving up. But okay, how long does that take? Probably like 25, or no, probably more like 15 minutes to get through blind, maybe. Well, maybe longer. It's not a terribly long level, but it's fun. And then we're out and about. And now I need to figure out a place in the world for this thing. Because the kind of nice thing about it is that I don't have to really focus on the shape of it, but let's just save and quit. And now... I have to figure out my actual, like, strategy for this thing. Oh, it's not that big at all, I think. Oh, wait, no, this is using the old mesh still. I'm gonna remove that. I'm going to get Blender out. Let's see, and I'm gonna eat pizza. So like I mentioned before, what I'm going to do is kind of the opposite of what I did in the other areas, where I've made like a proxy of the terrain and then built the thing around the terrain. I'm going to create a new thing, which is going to be a mesh that encapsulates... Oh. Encapsulates this whole thing, and it's going to encompass, and it's going to be what I actually bring into the world to like estimate where I want to put things. So to like I'm going to reasonably accurately approximate this terrain. So, like, let's just put it, like... And this will actually be the real bounding box for the chunk when it loads in. And let's see, and the entrance is the only part that really matters. Excuse me. So I'll try to be reasonably accurate with it. There we go. And let's, like, I don't know, sculpt a little bit now. I just realized, I don't think this thing is really used. So let's get rid of this part. And let's make it a bit more accurate. So this will be called gravity, or this will be, ref chunk grav gun. Let's see. Wait, I can just do... this. Oh, it's raining outside. I was like, what is that? It's just really coming down now. Well, hopefully my power doesn't go out again. I thought it was part of the song, and then I was like, it started giving me, I guess I'm having a weird anxiety about sounds recently. I think that thing with the smoke detector, that kind of destroyed my brain. Okay, I don't need this to be perfect. That's good enough. So this is now officially my reference. I don't need to go nuts with it. And then this will be what's exported. And then we can go to world. And this will do the same thing that it did before, but now when I do a custom chunk, let's do custom. It won't grow at all, so it'll just be the bounding box of the mesh. Because that was only because I was using that tiny cube at first, and then like a slightly janked version of the original mesh. And now let's get a new collection linked. So I need to go through, there. And now I can design the terrain around the object. Oh wait, I have to make a proxy. And that'll be called chunk graph gun. Can I rename it? All right, you know what? If I need it again, I'm just gonna append it. It's too much. They make it such a hassle. Like, I can't even move things that I import into the scene. Like, what is that? That's ridiculous. Okay, let's bring this in. Append it. So that way it's now just a thing that exists in the world. And let's get chunk grav gun. This thing is actually tiny, now that I look at it. But it is just a bit... A bit too, like, squared off, though. Maybe I need a larger entrance to it. Yeah, I'll do that. I need this actual, like, thing. I'll just make it all smooth. That'll be fun. Okay, so this way, if I hide this... Yeah, there we go. I also don't want to make it too complicated. Well, honestly, I probably should make it better. I wonder if I can edit the object's properties here. Yeah, I can. Also, somehow I accidentally deleted all of my low-res reference objects. Okay, now we're getting somewhere. So now I can just, like, slap this in anywhere, really, I think. And now I can, like, cross chunks and stuff. This is great, actually. So now I can just have... Where did I say I was gonna put it? Hang on. So I have my ultimate to do. Where's the gravity gun level? 127. Here? Why don't I... That's a dumb place. It's not even really compatible with it. But I guess it makes sense that it'll be further away from the other environment. Well, why am I... Actually, now that I think about it, why am I trying to put this square peg in a round hole? When I have the... When I made the square... Or the peg and the hole, I can do whatever I want. Like, I can just make the terrain fit this thing now. So let's do that. Because all I need is a little bit... Yeah, let's just put this... That's a little too obvious. Okay, I need to also... I'm in a hell of my own design with this setup. Because I have so many modifiers, and they are glacially slow. Oh my god, and it's not even... hang on. What? Wait, why is this one... one of these only had two modifiers. Why does this one... oh, okay, I know why. Because it's at the edge. Okay, now, I could please get this thing cooperative. So it'll be like this. And then I guess I'll have to just have, like, rocks around it, maybe? I know what to do. I'll do that later. I'll change the gravity chunk a little bit. But first I'll fiddle this just a little bit. Let's see, how obvious is it that I filled with the stuff? I don't think too obvious. But okay, so for this, I need to cut a hole. And what I'm gonna do actually... I'll extrude this back, because this is now going to do the same thing in the actual mesh. And that way, I don't have to deal with making this nearly as precise. Boom. And then I'll just need something there. In a low-res version. Okay, I guess first things first, I'm gonna check if this works. Because if I export this... what should happen is I can go up to it in the real world, in real life. Okay, I'm gonna mute and eat some more pizza and test this. The reflection probe. The reflection probe is messing it up now. I forgot about that. Uh-oh.
Hmm.
Yuck, and I love that shader compilation. Okay, and all my stuff is still saved because it's still, like, parented to the same object. Yeah, otherwise this thing is fine. So now I need to get the visuals, fix the bugs that I mentioned in the to-do list there. Then shelter this with rocks. Though I guess, Honestly, this is kind of a, now that I've done this, it's actually not a great system. Because, like, now I have to... Okay, what if I get the reflection probe here and apply that? I can't see the little selectors. I can't see the arrows. Okay, there they are. Excuse me, sorry for constantly clearing my throat so much. Okay, so what I can do is I can add this as a child here, and then I can play with it here, and then I can bring it into the other scene. Because now I have these extents. Okay, and this won't be bad, because it is very boxy, fundamentally. And I think I'll do it in, like, three reflection probes? Or four? Yeah, four reflection probes, I think. Well... Okay, so that gets that. I'll need a bit of this. I'll need a bit of this. This and this. I don't need it. And I won't even adjust the interior and exterior stuff here. I wonder, I might be able to do this. like cross it across multiple things. Not quite. And that doesn't solve that issue there. This doesn't get this. Okay, so let's go to here. Let's get my reflection probes. Merge from scene. Oh, I didn't save it yet. No, that's not. What? Do I have to close? Hang on. I think I have to close everything. And then I can open this. And then we can merge from scene. There we go. Yeah, goddammit, I don't have a... Well, actually, for starters, I don't think this thing is necessary at all, this, Eventually, I will eventually figure out how to get all this stuff. First of all, let's narrow this down, get it to where I want it. Okay, and this actually gives us a really good place to transition from interior to exterior, right there. Then everything else in here is going to be kind of a... I'll just say it'll all be kind of this dark blue-gray. Is this what it was before? And this stuff doesn't need to cover nearly as much as I'm seeing here. I probably should have made that proxy, like, actually conform a little bit better to the shape that I needed, but oh well. Because, like, this one especially, is like nothing. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bring these back into the other scene. Yeah, like this goes like 5 times further than it needs to in this direction. In fact, this one is the easiest because I can just make it go like this. So let's get this covering everything except for this little tower, I think, is going to be just fine. Because I'm going to get that little tower in its own reflection probe. So that way it covers just as little as possible of, like, this other areas. I'll put this right there. So that way there's like plenty of stuff for it to catch. So it looks interesting, but it's also not too much. You know, because it's not too obvious what it's actually reflecting here. Oh wait, hang on, what does this one capture? Oh, that explains that. This one should be, like, here, then. How much of this is needed? Okay, so only this thing, and then these things here. So this can be narrowed down a little bit. There we go. And I may want to get this in 2 reflection probes now. Let's make this like kind of purple, I think would be neat. So I think this one, yeah, I think I need to do this in what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 reflection probes. That's not bad. Next, I'll have a final one to cover all this lower area. Actually, I could pull this one up. I wonder if that would be better. I don't know. I won't do that for now. Let's put this one somewhere interesting. Oh, this needs to be... I'll get it in this reflection probe too. I'll just raise this up a little bit more. So that way we get everything. And every light, except for these two. Wait, what are these two? These need distance visible. Excuse me. I guess the final thing is, well, I guess I gotta bring this back into the, well, I know, I'll just test here. And that gives me an excuse to eat more pizza while I just silently walk around and examine it. If it doesn't crash. All right, that looks pretty good. See, so this isn't a terrible way of working, but it is... I don't know. Every way that I do this has flaws, unless I'm, like, really invested in tools to make it super easy to, like, edit things across different stuff. Wait, hang on. Why is this proxy? Why is that there? What is that? That shouldn't be here. Oh, okay. That was because I imported it at some point and didn't realize. That's fine. See, I want this one to be a little bit brighter, this area. So that way it just gets a little bit darker as you round this corner. And then this area. I could tweak it to be a little bit more like this color. So that way there's just a subtle hue variation. It's kind of not subtle though. I'll do just a smidge green and a smidge bright. Okay, now begins the process of, I guess, doing a few things. So, first thing, how far do these go? I'm gonna make it so that this is a separate object. So right here, it's gonna transition into another node. What? Did I merge it to something? Hang on, what the hell is this? Center of mass surface? Okay. Must be because there's something weird with the... Because it's an interior facing thing. So I must have been getting all weird with it. I have a much better idea for this. This way I don't have to mess up so much stuff. So I think this should be lower. that gets me to here, and then from here I'm going to do well, I really should have just made that there. SX0. Okay, so let's have this be the kind of like interface here where it's like well, what exactly do I want here? I guess maybe if I bring this in just a tiny bit. And then I bring it a little bit forward. There we go. Now it's a relatively seamless door transition. And so this will be called, like, entry. I'll say that the little rooms, I'll just decide on a case-by-case basis if I want to bother with, I guess making them look good. Well, actually. I can at least do this. Oh, and also now I can choose more deliberately if I want, or how I want this auto smooth to work. Because I think I'd want it to look more like this. Actually, now that I've done that, I like it more like this, where it's there's a subtle sort of intent, or, you know, indent there. Okay, so that gets us to there, and then I suppose this will be room one, so let's do that, and see, do I want to do it right here? Because with the door, I don't know if I can actually make the doors very seamless now that I think about it. Like, they aren't actually all that much easier to deal with than just other things. So this is now room one. And I may do something, yeah, I'll do something more structured also with the parenting, so that way there's like decent bounding boxes on all this stuff. And you know what, I'm gonna split it all off first. This is a good one because I don't actually ever separate this door. Let's see here. That's already separated. Thank you. Okay, now we've got a pretty good situation. Excuse me. So I'm going to go through these slowly. You know, just make some nice caps to them and stuff. Like here, what I think I'm gonna do. I think I'll leave that for the other side. Maybe even a separate door frame mesh? Oh well. So let's get this, this, and this. Yeah. And also I needed to fix these as well. I noticed those when I was playing. Yeah, I don't need that. Well, yeah. Actually, while I'm in here, let's get my bevels in. Do I need this? I don't think I need this anymore. Yeah. That looks good. Because I'll basically, just have that come up a little bit. And this. Hopefully, this doesn't trip the player up. I think the player model, or I think the player controller is robust enough that it can handle this. This very, very tiny slope. But yeah, that'll be enough to make that smooth. I forgot, the entire point of that was because I wanted to do this. I don't want to fiddle too much with the actual, like, geometry of the world, so I'm just going to do that there. And then up here, I'm going to try this with a bevel and see how badly that messes up the geometry. Yeah, as I suspected. What was the point of that? Oh, right. That was, all of that was so that I can bevel this. Oh, I made the same mistake over here. So I'm just gonna make it not so weird looking here. Yeah, now ideally I can do this. Yeah, and I don't blow up the whole world. And I might be able to do it here with similarly not destructive results. That should hint to the player pretty strongly that there's something there. And I'll also do, just for decorative effect, and I also wanted these. So these are going to be So those will be two little mysterious doors that go off to nowhere. Because I need way more of those. And eventually I will parent these doors to something as well, but I'll fiddle with it once I get everything else done. So this will be the spoke. Or this will be like center. Actually, let's see if I can get... I'll put these in there right now. And I can see if I can reattach signals. Go nowhere, so let's put them attach them already. Oh. Object keep transform. Oh wait, that's gonna... that'll lose all the animation players, but I wanted to change them anyway to make them, like, doors, or, like, separate objects. Ah, well. Let's name this something nice. Hallway 1. Dash collision. I guess that can stay as one room. These long hallways may actually be the issue, or an issue, because they'll intersect with a bunch of different lights, but oh well. And why not? Let's rename everything as well. Wait, what did I parent this to? Uh-oh. Okay, so this is in charge of all this stuff, but what did I parent it to? Oh wait, no, I didn't parent it to anything. I need to, yeah. Oh wait, if this is parented, oh wait, this is something else. Oh, that's funny. So I guess I should parent it then to this. So this will be, what did I attach this to? I'll just do it like this. let's get the remainder of these. So these are some things. And this just might indicate to the player that they need to use this. Okay, what else do I want here? Are these part of this? I'm gonna make all of this children of this area. I also need to add the weird thing. So this will be called Combat Arena. And since I'm attaching everything to everything, I'll have to redo like everything. Or at least all the door logic. Which I guess won't be bad. see, let's just call this extra. Room 2. See, what am I listening to? Suigetsu Maigokoro Omoide. Or Omoide. It sounds kind of like it's a bit too lullaby for me. Let's see if we can skip past it. Okay, I like how it uses the arrow buttons to just do whatever it wants. Okay, let's get this back in here. So I want I think something like this. And that gives me a little opportunity to like do this. I can like do that and then like there. And it is basically random if the player, wait, hang on, I'm gonna fiddle with this, because this doesn't need to be this bad looking. Wait, why is it? Hang on, it's so much. It's like weird. It's like. Ahem. guess in a perfect world, I wouldn't be doing this. I would be, like, focusing strictly on, like, gameplay stuff at this phase. Well, no, I guess not. Now that I've said that, this is fine. Because it's stuff that matters. Because if the little details suck and, like, the lights are blinking in and out, that will affect a person's ability to enjoy the rest of the game. Because it is, like, you know, all you can do is either play the mechanics or, like, look at cool stuff. So this will be floating. Maybe this will be like, yeah, I'll call it floating room. And I named this control room 3, or room, but I'll just call it control room 3. See, let's hide all this stuff. So I'm gonna gradually, like, narrow down which objects I still haven't really, like, touched, because there's stuff in the center still. this thing has a bizarre center of mass. Hang on, I'm gonna relocate that. Yeah, there we are. So what's this called? Okay, so that's room 3. That looks good. And that may very well... Yep, okay. Now everything is properly parented, and then I need to go through and make sure everything is, like, beveled properly. That's gonna be, annoying. Let's see. What can I do to speed this up? Well, one... Oh, right. These aren't parented to anything, I guess. Okay, so now... I might just make everything a child of the center. Yeah, why not? Because it's all one unit. And that way... I can add stuff, and it won't, like, mess up the tree as much as it used to. Alright, so I'll need to fix up those seams. But for now... So it's about 8. Let's see. Gravity gun level... Where did I put my to-do stuff? I guess in here, maybe? Oh, here it is. Levels. So, gravity cannon level. Split mission lights. So this will be... So this was the pistol level that I'm fixing up, so... Let's just say... Fix up the gravity cannon level. So I think... Yeah, that's all good. Add bevels, put baubles and enemies right next to elevator to encourage shooting it, make one of the initial baubles lower so the player can jump on it, split mesh for lights, fix it. Okay, so let's do... So I got that done. Fix seams between meshes. Reapply materials. Fix doors. Make nodes independent of tree. But the animation players would break anyway, so maybe I don't care. Plus, hopefully this is the last time for a while that I have to fiddle with this thing. I guess for now what I should do is I'm gonna do these two. In the last few minutes that we have. Because those I can test without actually, like, using... Without actually, like, working the doors. Oh, and then I need to put rocks in front of it. Bells to floor. But but not too much, because I want it to be... Actually, I could maybe even make the rocks, like, telegraph that it's here. Because I want to make it relatively obvious to the player that this is a thing of interest. And what better way to do that than to pretend to try to hide it? Oh wait, and I don't need these reflection probes anymore. Alright. Oh wait, also. Implement distant mesh. So yeah, so now all the materials are all like horribly ruined. But that's okay. Because I'm going to make... Let's see. What was I going to do? Right, I need to lower... I'll make it obvious, so this will be like 6. Yeah, so that way, it's like, oh, okay, so like maybe. Well, hang on. How high does it have to be? I want it to be that the player doesn't have to think about it too hard. So yeah, I think it needs to be like 3, and then... Wait, where the hell... Why did everything move? Did I move this by accident? Because I feel like it's not where it's supposed to be. Is it? No, it's not where it is. Like this thing. I moved the whole... how the fuck did I do that? Wait, was this one... hang on, I need to like... Okay, let's go through this very, very slowly. Okay, let's close this whole thing, because clearly something isn't working here. Go to Chunk's Chunk Gravity Gun. So the gravity gun should not be up here. It should be down here. And then I will not select it, and I will save it. It went up. Why did it go up? That isn't... Okay, and also, yeah, so all these animation players, they'll get out of here. I don't need those. And all these switches, I'm also gonna disconnect their signals for now. Oh, they're already disconnected, I think. Yeah, okay. Then, very surgically, okay, so it was because there were animation players. That is interesting, but dumb. Okay. Okay, and those are good. And now, with the precision of a surgeon, excise my foul little miscreant things. And someday I'll even return the LOD system. I don't know where that went. I genuinely have, like, there's nothing in here to delete those low-res things. Okay, let's see if I can, with all of my wits, successfully apply the material to multiple things. I think, yeah, they don't. Some of them don't have two materials for some reason. I should also signal another elevator to the player at some point. Well, I guess there's always another, there's always more levels. Because I was thinking, like, I should probably tutorialize multiple elevators. But, I don't know, it's the centerpiece. And I don't want to add more stuff now that I've gone through all this work. And I guess for now. Oh wait, no. I think everything here should collide with the camera as well as those doors did. And then the last things. I think. These also need to go there. Okay, and even with all the lights visible, I'm not seeing any flickering, so that's a good sign. Who knew that having, like, enormous, like, level-spanning meshes was actually bad for graphics? I think for my next level, I'm going to try to practice making, like, modular pieces beforehand instead of, like, making a big thing and then splitting it up. Oh. Okay, so my goal with this is that if the player just shoots all of these and gets all of them up at once, it just works out for them. It doesn't. Did I somehow undo what I had done before? I did, I think. So I think this has to go like 3, and then this can go like 6 maybe? let's try this again. All right, that's just begging the player to like do this well. Not well. Why did this one go like that? I think this one needs to be at 10. Maybe this one can be at 6. And this one as well. Yeah, there we go. So yeah, it's literally begging the player to, like, progress. And then the next thing was adding some baubles and a couple enemies on the elevator to get that going. So let's just hide all this. Put him, and we'll put a bobble just like right here or something. And let's maybe put a few enemies. So these guys, and this guy's not going to respawn, because these guys are just for the tutorial. The elevator doesn't work anymore. That makes complete sense. What was it? So it's an elevator, and it's gonna have like 25 initial velocity, and also 0, 0. And I'll have to fix the doors. So let's reload so that the script applies. So that's too much. I don't want to, like, catapult the player up into the air. And I'll do, less spinning. Or maybe, like... Oh wait, did those guys not respawn? Where'd they go? I also need to give them custom awareness. I'll add that right now to my notes, but I don't want to do it today. Implement distant mesh. Custom awareness. On death gnat trio. So I think I did those decently. Because if the player doesn't know what to do, hopefully they'll shoot that bobble, assuming that there's like some puzzle related to it, and then the elevator will go up. And let's see. Oh, okay. That's the reflection that's tripping me up, I think. No, it's not. I don't think anything, honestly. That does seem like a reflection, though. I don't know. I'll just have to fix the seams between the mesh tomorrow, I think. It's almost there. It's getting there. Oh, hang on, the windows. Can't tell if it runs smoother or if that's just in my brain. Yeah, so it's very likely that if they hit that directly, they'll activate the elevator as well. And hopefully they don't get too tripped up by the fact that they can't jump on these when they're moving. And hopefully they try that with that. Because it may be one of those situations where they like try, where they like accidentally make it harder on themselves by like being like, oh, so I have to like jump on it right as it's going. So like, you know, because they probably won't know to about the holding R to detonate it remotely. Yeah, so they might. Ooh, there's a weird sound in my left ear that scared me. I don't know if that picked up in the audio, or if that was like a weird thing with my headphones or something. That was scary. Well, whatever. I can't win them all. If there's a weird sound in your left earbud when you're playing the game, I didn't fix it. I didn't even investigate. But let's put all this into Git. Did I ever show the fact that the water works? Oh, I guess I did. That was, wow, so long ago, 3 hours ago. I completely forgot. I guess I'm not really beginning the art pass because it's like, I want to get like an actual artist to do the art pass, but I am doing a visual pass on it. Did I push this? And I'll say, I'm also hearing that rumbling again. I think it is just my neighbors have like a big subwoofer or something. But sometimes I don't think they're listening. I think they must be watching movies or something with it. But oh well. Alright, I think that'll be it for today. This has been pretty fun. Let's see. Come back tomorrow and I'll be doing the exciting task of re-implementing the things that I broke with this pass. See you then.